G'day. Welcome to this fourth and last video in my series on how to find the derivatives of compound functions. In my previous three videos, I've dealt with the chain rule, the product rule, and the quotient rule. And in this shorter video, I propose to show how you can use those three structures to find the derivatives of more complicated functions. Now, I'm not going to go through the theory of the six basic functions anymore. I assume you've looked at those videos and you know what I'm talking about. All I propose to do is to solve or to find the derivatives of two compound functions for you and to show you how the structure helps you find those derivatives with considerable ease and speed. So, without wasting time, let's see how the structure helps. I'm going to create a compound function here with a product on the top. Let's make it e to the 6x log x plus 1 and something fairly complicated on the bottom like x cubed cos to the fifth power of 7x. And I think you'll agree that's a good deal more complex than most questions, or perhaps any question you have in your school textbook. Perhaps if you're at university, you might find this useful as well. But how do we find the derivative? Actually, I'm going to retain the blue pen and set the structure up. Remember, since the overall picture here is a quotient or a fraction, where we have one function over another, so I'm going to set up the structure with a very long vinculum and square the bottom. Now, squaring x cubed is easy, and squaring the cosine of the fifth power will give us cosine to the tenth power of 7x. So we've squared the denominator. We know it's going to involve a minus sign because it's a quotient rule, and we're going to have the derivative of the top multiplied by the bottom, so I'm going to write the x cubed cos to the fifth 7x. And in the second part of the expression, we're going to leave the top alone and multiply by the derivative of the bottom. So what I've done is I've already drawn out the structure that takes care of the quotient part of the derivative. Now, when we find the derivative of the numerator, to put it here, we have a product of two functions. It's a product rule. So I know that I'm going to have two expressions added together. In fact, I know more than that. I know that I'm going to find the derivative of e to the 6x and multiply it by log of x plus 1. And then I'm going to leave the e to the 6x alone and write down the logarithm of x plus 1 there. Similarly, when I come to find the derivative of this denominator, it also is a product of x cubed times cos to the fifth power of 7x. Consequently, its derivative is going to appear as a sum of two terms or two expressions in here. And I'm going to have a derivative of x cubed times cos to the fifth power of 7x plus x cubed times the derivative of cos to the fifth power of 7x. What I've done now is I've put the structure for the product rules here. So you can see, first of all, I dealt with the quotient rule, then the product rule, and now all that I'm left with are small chain rules. Small chains. Here I must do the derivative of e to the 6x, which is itself, so the derivative of the exponential is itself, times the derivative of the function inside, which is derivative of 6x is 6, times whatever's left. Then I leave this alone and I find the derivative of log of x plus 1. Well, the derivative of log is 1 over whatever's inside, times the derivative of whatever's inside. When I come to find this, I find the derivative of x cubed is 3x squared times the cosine of the fifth power of 7x plus the x cubed I leave alone, and then I find the derivative cos to the fifth power of 7x, which is actually a little bit longer than this. So I should leave, I should have that bracket a little bit further over. I deal with the fifth power first, so it's going to be 5 cos to the fourth power of 7x times, I might have to work above here, times the derivative cosine is minus sine of 7x, and then multiply by the derivative of 7x, which is 7. And there it is, in one line we've completed the derivative of that compound function. Now of course you have, this is quite an horrific example, and you would have a substantial amount of sorting out to do algebraically. But in fact, the derivative has been found. And I want you to learn to use this structure so that with simpler examples you can find derivatives very, very quickly indeed. Let's do one more. Sorry. Let's do another quotient. Log x, I'm trying to give a variety of functions here, e to the tan 7x, for example. And on the bottom we might put x cubed sine squared 5x. So how do we find the derivative of this compound function? Again, very long bar, very long vinculum. We square the bottom. Just realize that's not very different from what I had. So it just means doubling those indices. We draw the minus sign in, and we're going to have the derivative of this times this. So I'm going to write my x cubed sine squared 5x, and then we're going to have the numerator log x e to the tan 7x times the derivative of what's on the bottom. So our structure has been put in place for the quotient rule. Now let's deal with this product on top. We have a product of two functions. So I'm going to put brackets. By the way, the square ones are genuinely brackets. I'm a traditionalist. I learned the original names of things. The bent ones are parentheses, and the curly ones are called braces. People who never learned that the names for those particular grouping symbols call them curly brackets and square brackets and curvy brackets or something, but they're originally parentheses, brackets and braces, and you'll just have to put up with my using those terms. Now, since we're finding the derivative of a product, we know we're going to have two expressions added. We're going to find the logarithm, derivative of the logarithm times e to the tan 7x, and then we're going to leave the logarithm alone and find the derivative of that. Over here we're going to find another product, because I have a product on the bottom. We'll find the derivative of x cubed times the sine squared 5x. And then we'll leave the x cubed alone and find the derivative of sine squared 5x. Now, I really don't have room to fit these in, so I'm going to stack them a little bit with my red ink. What's the derivative of log x? Well, it's quite simple. So we find the derivative of log x is 1 over x times what remains. Leave the log x. Derivative of this? Well, the derivative of e to the tan, e to anything, is itself. Then we multiply by, and I'm going to have to squeeze this in above, we multiply by the derivative of the tangent, which is 6 squared, 7x, and then we multiply by the derivative of the function inside that, which is 7. I hope you can see we had, this structure gave us the quotient rule, this structure gave us the product rule, here and here, and now we're building in the chain rules. Derivative of x cubed is 3x squared. Then we leave the sine squared 5x alone. Leave the x cubed here, and the derivative of sine squared 5x is 2 sine 5x, that deals with the power of 2, times the derivative of sine is cos, times the derivative of the function 5x inside. Now again, you have a great deal of sorting out to do there, expanding grouping symbols and in some cases gathering like terms and such like. A rather messy, nasty bit of algebra there. What I've demonstrated in these two examples here is how to find the derivatives of quite complex compound functions. And I hope that's been of help to you. Now, you're not going to find a great number of these in your school textbook. If you can get access to university level textbooks, you will. And you may be able to find some sources of them on the internet. You might find that your teachers have access to sets of them. Wherever you source your examples from, I encourage you to practice finding the derivatives of compound functions like this, because if you can do this, you'll certainly be able to find the derivatives of the most complicated functions they'll give you in your external examinations at school. Thank you very much for watching. I encourage you to subscribe to my channel to find out about future videos. And please leave a comment and like this video as well. Thank you.